Today we're going to be showing you the best hidden features for the brand new Samsung Galaxy S10 and S10 Plus. Let's get started. The first hidden feature we have is absolutely incredible. It allows you to add the brand new night mode onto your Galaxy S10 or S10 Plus device. So to access this, just go to your settings, click on display, and then in display, you can see that there's a new night mode that uses a darker theme. It helps your eyes see better at night. And trust me, this works very well. So just click the night mode button like so. And as you can see, all of the whites turned black. And this is going to allow you to see a lot better at night. It's a lot easier on the eyes, but it's not just the settings app. It's a wide variety of your applications that support night mode, like the calculator. Take a look at this. The calculator is now all black, like so. Even changes what the letters show up as. So as you can see, they show up as white. Now, if we exit out and we take a look at, let's say, the Google app, for instance, you can see that this actually has a dark theme as well. If we go to the search, you can see that the keyboard is dark themed. Now, one other thing that you can do is if you open another app that fully has a dark theme, such as your phone, let's just agree to that, still setting up everything on here. But as you can see, if you take a look at the keypad, you can see that the entire screen is dark in that night mode. Now, if we go back, I wanna show you the difference that we have here. If we switch away from night mode and we go back to one of these other apps, such as your phone app, or if you go over to the calculator app like so, you can see that it switches back to a very bright white. So this is gonna be a lot easier on the eyes switching over to this night mode available right here in the settings application as a hidden feature. All right, let's take a look at the next hidden feature on your Samsung Galaxy S10. With your Galaxy S10, you can now take full use of gestures. And so the way that works is if you swipe up, you go to settings, and you're going to go to display, and then you're going to scroll down until you see the navigation bar. Now the navigation bar, of course, is right here at the bottom. It has your home button, your multitask switcher, the back button. But what if you wanted, instead of that, to actually activate full screen gestures? So now, instead of clicking the buttons, you have gestures. This is similar to the iPhone XS or the iPhone model, where you don't actually have the buttons at the bottom, you have different gestures. So each of these areas has the same gestures they represented before. So if you swipe up on the far left, you're going to go into your multi-app switcher. You can see here, you can switch between apps. If you swipe up right in the center, you're gonna go home like so. We swipe up here, you can see we can go right back. And if you swipe up over here on the right, you can see that you can quickly switch to the previous app you had open. So it has those same button functionality. See, we can exit out just like so. We can go into our multitask area. It's just adding gestures to it, which is really, really valuable. So if we go back into the navigation bar, you can see that we can also disable the gesture hints. You can see there's little bars at the bottom. If we turn that off, then we really get a completely free screen experience where you can see we don't have those bars reminding us or taking up the screen, but we can still access those gestures and use them. Let me know in the comments below if you like the navigation bar or if you're using gestures. I'm curious to see. This next hidden feature is really simple, but also very handy. So you all know you can swipe up to access your applications on the home screen. You can also swipe down and that accesses the applications as well. But in order to get your notifications, you have to swipe all the way from the top. What if you could just swipe down and instead of getting your apps, get your notifications? Well, you can actually enable that in the settings. So let's swipe up, go to our settings application, click on display, and then in display, what you're gonna do is you're gonna scroll down until you see home screen. Click on home screen, and then as you see here, you can scroll down a little bit until you see quick open notification panel. Select that icon, let's go back out, and now, still, when you swipe up, you get the apps, but when you swipe down, you get your notifications from anywhere on the screen. You don't just have to swipe down from the top, you can swipe down directly from the center of the screen. Now, this is really simple, but I find it very handy. And be sure, if you guys are learning something new, be sure to hit that like button. Let us know what your favorite hidden features are in the comments below, especially if they weren't featured on this video. We've got a lot more. Just want to remind you, if you're finding this valuable, hit that like button. We really appreciate it. All right, let's take a look at the next hidden feature. So as you can see on the Galaxy S10, it has an incredible camera built in, and it really does blend into the phone. But maybe you just don't want to see that unsightly little, not really notch, but little hole that your camera has right there. And what I would say is you can actually go ahead and add a bar at the top of the screen that hides your camera. So if you go to settings and then you go to display and you scroll down and you see where it says full screen apps, and then you can click this icon right here that says hide front camera. Watch this. If you take a look there, you could see that the camera almost disappears because you're adding a bar at the top of the screen, right where the camera is, across the whole screen. So now it's no longer obvious that you have that camera there taking up space. Now again, it doesn't take up that much space and not as much space as the notch in the iPhone XS. However, it can be a little bit unsightly, especially if you're playing mobile games on your device, racing games, whatever it happens to be. So if you click that icon, as you can see, it turns the entire top into one black bar that hides the camera very well. So this is a neat hidden feature. You may not want to actually activate this one, but it's good to know that it exists. This next one's pretty quick, but it's for people like me who like to see what the battery percentage is on your phone. Now, obviously, you can see up here to a degree how much battery you have left, but if you really want to know the exact percentage, especially if you're getting right down to the end of your battery, then you can easily add that to your device. Just go to the settings application, and then what you're gonna do is scroll to notifications, not scroll, it's right at the top, notifications, then status bar. And as you can see here, you can choose show battery percentage, and that'll actually show the percentage of your battery right up at the top. That's just a quick one, but it can be pretty handy, especially if your phone is starting to lose battery quickly. Next hidden feature we have allows you to take a long screenshot of an entire page. Even if the page goes on, you could take just one screenshot and have it automatically capture the entire page. So let's show you how that works. So you'll go ahead and enable the screenshot either by pressing the volume down and the power button, or by doing the swipe feature over the screen. And as you can see right here, you have tap scroll. So if you tap on this, you can see that it's actually going to scroll down and capture more of the screen, creating a much longer screenshot, just like so. You can go all the way down to the bottom of the screen, and then let's say we click on this right here, you can see it's the entire screen automatically captured, just like so. So this is a very valuable hidden feature, especially if you're trying to take a screenshot of an article or something a little bit longer. So we've got a lot more hidden features coming up, but right now I want to take a quick break to show you an incredible app called QuickThoughts that allows you to earn Google Play gift cards, Amazon gift cards, even PayPal cash, just by taking simple surveys on your device. So we're gonna show you exactly how you can get this app and start earning cash just by taking surveys. So now I'm gonna show you how you can get this incredible app on your phone so you can start earning cash and gift cards by taking simple surveys. So open up your Google Chrome browser and you're gonna wanna go to this exact URL. Make sure you type in this exact URL in order to get started and get the best surveys. You also help to support the show. So it's bit.ly/getquickthoughts, just like this, bit.ly/getquickthoughts. The link is right here on the screen and also down in the description. Click go, and then this is going to instantly take you to the Google Play Store where you're gonna be able to install the QuickThoughts application. We're gonna do this quickly and we'll be right back. Once the app's done downloading, just click open, and as you can see, we can go directly into QuickThoughts. We're gonna wanna click sign up, and as you can see, they want your opinion to count. So click register, and all you have to do is fill out some simple information, accept the terms and conditions, And as you can see here, they've already given out over $17.4 million to their QuickThoughts members. This goes up all the time. They have lots of ways to earn money just by completing simple surveys. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is create your new user profile. Because you did sign up using our link, bit.ly/getQuickThoughts, you're gonna be qualified to get some of the best surveys on this app, where you could earn anywhere from a few dollars, 50 cents, a few dollars, even $10 plus, just by taking simple surveys. You do have to create your profile, so just click here, fill out some simple information, and once you do that, you can start using QuickThoughts on your own. So go to bit.ly/getQuickThoughts in order to download the app today and start earning. As I said before, they've given out over $17.4 million already, and you can get your piece of that too. They also help to support the show, so go to bit.ly/getQuickThoughts and get started today. Link will be in the description. All right, let's take a look at some more hidden features. So you probably already know you can take a screenshot of your screen by selecting the power button and volume down at the same time, just like so. You may not know that you can also take a screenshot using the palm screenshot, just like this, by swiping your palm over the screen, almost like you're copying the screen. But that's not the hidden feature. The hidden feature I want to show you is how to actually create a custom shortcut using the power button and volume up, which, as you can see right now, doesn't do anything, but we can actually customize this. You guys are going to want to follow along. So go into your settings application, scroll down until you get to accessibility, click on accessibility, and then you're going to go to advanced settings. And as you can see right here, we have power and volume keys. Now, right now, this is off by default. What you want to do is turn this on. And as you can see, there's a wide variety of selections that you can use with this custom shortcut. But for this example, I'm going to use the magnifier window. So take a look at this. Now, when we press the power button and volume up, it pops open a magnifying glass that we can use right here on the screen. As you can see, we can use this to magnify what we're looking at. We can actually move it around. And this is just one of the custom features you can use. You can set this up for voice assistant, universal switch, negative colors. Let's try that one. So let's say we wanted to do negative colors, just like that. It switches it into, this isn't the same as the night mode, this actually switches all of the colors, but it switches it into negative color mode, and to go out of that, just press the button again. So this is really cool, a hidden feature you probably didn't know about. Right here in accessibility, you can add a custom shortcut for the power plus volume up. And remember, if you guys are learning something new, be sure to share this video with your friends and let us know what your favorite hidden features are in the comments. Like the video. All right, let's take a look at the next hidden feature. You can now actually enable landscape mode for your home screen. As you can see, it doesn't work when you just try to turn your phone, and that's because you have to enable it. You go into settings, and then you're going to go to display, and then scroll down to home screen. And then as you can see here, we have rotate to landscape mode right at the bottom. Click on rotate to landscape mode. And as you can see, we can now actually access a landscape mode version of our home screen just like this. It is pretty fun. It's a hidden feature. Again, maybe not something I would do all the time, but it's good to know that this feature exists. Now, I love how big the Samsung Galaxy S10 and especially the S10 Plus is. It's just incredible. But sometimes that can be a lot to manage, especially if you're just trying to use one hand. So now I want to show you how to access the hidden one-handed mode in your Samsung Galaxy S10. So just go into the settings area, and then you're going to scroll until you see advanced features. Click on advanced features, and then what we're going to do is go to motions and gestures. And as you can see right here, we have the one-handed mode that we can enable. So when we enable this, all you have to do to access one-handed mode is just swipe down from the top left or top or middle left or middle right. You can also swipe back to exit out. So as you can see here, let's say we had our keyboard up or we're trying to scroll through the screen, we can access everything right here within the range of a thumb. So watch this, we swipe back up, we swipe down, now everything's accessible with just one hand. Now, you can also change this to be button as well, and that way you can triple click the home button, like so, and that will access a different type of one-handed mode right here. As you can see, this is actually bringing the entire screen into view. So those are two different ways that you can use the one-handed mode right here on your Galaxy S10. The next hidden feature we have is a little more serious, and I encourage everyone watching this video to enable this feature just in case. Hopefully you never have to use it, but just to be prepared and just in case, this is the Emergency SOS feature on your Galaxy S10. And again, I encourage all of you to enable this just to be safe. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go into your settings app and you're gonna scroll down to advanced features and click on advanced features right here. And then scroll down until you see send SOS messages. Click on that. And as you can see by default, this is actually turned off. You want to turn this on, click okay, agree to the terms and conditions. And then as you can see here, what you're able to do is add recipients to your SOS messages. So click add, you can create a new contact, you can put in the name and phone number that you need to put in for your emergency SOS. Now, as you can see here, when you click the power key three times, it will send a quick alert to all of your emergency contacts that you choose in here that will let them know you're in an emergency situation. This is incredibly useful and very discreet. Again, hopefully you never have to use this, but having this enabled could save you from a very dangerous situation. You could even reach into your pocket, just press the power key three times, just like so, one, two, three. And then what that's gonna do, and obviously I don't have it enabled right now, is that would send the emergency alert. Hold on, let me just log back in here. There we go. That will send the emergency alert to your contacts. Now you can also choose to have pictures attached as well as audio recording. I recommend keeping these on. They're on by default when you turn this on, and that's going to let people know a little bit better what's going on with your situation. So make sure that you enable this. Again, I'm gonna show you where it is again because I think this is so important. You're gonna go to the settings, you're gonna go to advanced features, you're gonna scroll down until you see send SOS messages right here, and then just click enable. Add the contacts that you want as your emergency contacts, and then if you ever get into a dangerous situation, you know you can just press this power button three times to alert your emergency contacts. Again, hopefully you never have to use it, but it's better to be safe and enable this. The next thing I want to show you isn't a hidden feature, but it's actually a hidden app that allows you to save a lot of money every time you're shopping online. It is absolutely incredible. The app is called Ebates, and I'm gonna show you how you can not only get a $10 bonus when you sign up, but also save money at places you'd shop anyways. So you're gonna wanna follow along, open up Google Chrome, and go to this exact URL. It's also down there in the description. It's bit.ly/getEbates. Bonus, just like this. It's bit.ly/GETEBATES BONUS. Get Ebates bonus. Just like that. It's right here on the screen and in the description. So when you go to this URL, you're actually gonna get $10 just for signing up and making your first purchase with Ebates. Now, Ebates allows you to save money at literally thousands of online stores that you can purchase at, that you probably are shopping at anyways. So all you gotta do is sign up right here, and now let's go into Ebates and show you exactly how this works. Once you sign up, you'll see just how incredible Ebates is. As you can see, you can earn cash back at stores you'd shop at anyways. So let's take a look at Macy's, for example. I know I do a lot of clothes shopping at Macy's, and as you can see here, you can get 6% cash back. All you have to do, it's as simple as this, is click shop now. And as you can see, it says 6% cashback activated, and then just shop at Macy's as normal. This 6% is added on top of any other coupons, website deals, sales that are already on the store. As you can see, there's already 20% off. You're gonna get an additional 6% cashback at the very end of your bill, which is incredible. Also, remember, when you go to bit.ly/getEbatesbonus, you get a free $10 gift card or $10 in cash back just by making one purchase through any of these sites. It doesn't have to be Macy's. It can be any of the sites on here. Now, this is one of my other favorite features. You can see down here, it says 70 deals. So not only do you get 6% cash back, But there's also a wide variety of deals available, and you can take a look here and actually shop those deals too. So if we go back, you can see that you can get any of these deals plus 6% cash back on top of your purchase. So if we go out, you can see that there's a lot of different stores. Sephora, Groupon, Old Navy, Shoes.com. Some of these are very, very high. You can see Under Armour, Booking.com, Tom's, Blue Apron, Gap, Target, L.L. Bean, GameStop. There is a wide variety of different stores that are available with cashback. If you're not using Ebates, you're leaving money on the table. So they're our sponsor for this episode. I recommend going to bit.ly/getEbatesbonus to get your $10 bonus when you make your first purchase and save on all your online purchases. This isn't a hidden feature, but it's definitely a hidden app worth downloading. All right, let's take a look at the next hidden feature. So you can actually change the edge lighting on your Samsung Galaxy S10 or S10 Plus just by going into settings, and then you're gonna scroll down until you see display, scroll to edge screen right here, and as you can see, you have edge lighting enabled. Now that's the light around the edge of the screen, and you can actually change this. So if you take a look here, you can change the edge lighting style right here to be a different style. You can see that this one's currently the default blue style, but you can actually change the color. Let's say you wanted red, and you can see how that appears red around the screen. Remember, it's very subtle, but this is something that you can change whenever you're closing apps or opening apps. You can have this nice edge effect. You can even choose any color that you want, as you can see, and you can set that up as the new color. When you're ready, just click done, and you can actually change the transparency, the width. So let's say you want this a little bit wider. You can see there, that's a lot more pronounced. And you can even choose the duration. So instead of it being short, you could have it last a little bit longer. So I think this is a really fun effect that you can play around with and really customize to make your own. So remember, you're gonna go there by going into the edge lighting section from edge screen in the display. So display, edge screen, edge lighting style, and you can change the effect. One quick addition is you're not limited to just the standard edge screen effect. You can also choose other ones like the wave, as you can see here, or even bubbles, like so. You can also choose a multicolor effect as well, which is a lot of fun. So there's a few different effects that you can choose in addition to being able to change the color, transparency, width, and everything we just showed you. There's a lot of different incredible ways that you can customize your keyboard right here on your Galaxy S10. So to do this, you're just gonna go into settings, scroll down until you see general management, click on general management, language and input, and then as you can see here, you can click on screen keyboard and Samsung keyboard. Now with this Samsung keyboard, there's a lot of different things that you can do. You can go into smart typing. As you can see, it's got predictive text. A lot of this is already enabled. But what I wanted to show you is how you can actually change the keyboard layout by clicking keyboard layout and feedback. Now, this is really cool. Now, it has the keyboard toolbar by default right here, as you can see, that has a lot of functionality. But the other thing that's really amazing here is you can actually change the keyboard themes. So you can go between light and dark, like so, as you can see, just like that. But you can also have an adaptive theme. So you can see here, this is the dark theme, like so. Then you have the light theme. What I want to recommend turning on is the adaptive theme. And what this means is it's gonna switch to a light or dark theme depending on what app you have open, whether you're in night mode or not. So if you select this, now it's actually going to adapt to whether or not your screen is more light or more dark. Click apply, and that's a great feature that's gonna allow you to customize your keyboard. Now, another thing too here, you can actually change the size and transparency of your keyboard as well. So you can go in here and actually change a little bit more details about your keyboard. As you can see, we can actually increase or decrease the size and transparency of the keys. So there's a lot of fun things to experiment with right here in the keyboard settings. Now I'm gonna show you a couple hidden features that have to do with your camera. Now, of course, the Galaxy S10 has an incredible camera setup, both in the front and the rear, and we're gonna show you how to maximize that. So go into the settings of your camera, and what you're gonna be able to do if you scroll down is actually change the definition of your video. So you can see here, rear video size If you click on resolution, you can actually change it to 4K 60 frames per second, just like so, to shoot absolutely stunning video using your Galaxy S10. Now you can similarly customize your front video as well. It doesn't go up to 60 frames per second, but you can also increase the dimensions that you have on that too. Now, if you take a look here, one other pro feature I want to show you, and you probably already knew about some of this, so this next one is really, truly a hidden feature. If you click on Advanced Recording Options, you have the brand new HDR 10 Plus video. Now, you have to go back out here, change the resolution back to its standard resolution right here. Actually, let's change it. I think we could change it there. And we go to advanced, and as you can see, we can change it to HDR 10 plus video. It just doesn't work at the 60 frames per second. So you can still have it at 4K, just not at 60 frames per second. And as you can see here, you can turn on HDR 10 plus video, which is absolutely stunning. It also looks great played back on the Galaxy S10 screen. Thank you for watching our video on the best hidden features for your brand new Samsung Galaxy S10 or S10 plus. Hopefully you found this video valuable, and be sure to like the video, share it with your friends so they can see all the best features, and subscribe for more videos coming soon. Now, remember, we showed you two incredible apps I highly recommend downloading. The first was QuickThoughts, which allows you to earn cash just by completing simple surveys. So go to bit.ly/getQuickThoughts to sign up and get your piece of over $17 million they give out. Don't forget to create your profile, because that's what's gonna allow you to get those high-paying surveys to earn cash and gift cards. We also showed you Ebates, where you can save cash back at a wide variety of stores you would shop at anyways. And remember, when you go to bit.ly/getEbatesbonus, you're gonna get a $10 bonus with the first purchase you make on top of the cash back. These are our sponsors for the episode. They help make this channel run, so be sure to use the link down there in the description to get started with these apps and start earning some awesome money and rewards just for shopping and taking surveys. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you found this video valuable, and let me know what your favorite hidden features are in the comments below, especially if we didn't include them in this episode. All right, I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye.